how I'm feeling. That's just how I'm feeling. Duh. I ain't trying to make a living. I'm out here trying to make a killer. Stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling.
Today, from Seattle, Washington, this is the NFL on EA Sports.
We are in the Pacific Northwest as we get set for football at Lumen Field here in the Southern District of Seattle.
Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Houston Texans and the Seattle Seahawks.
To about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Russell Wilson leads out the Seattle Seahawks offense. The veteran Wilson, a third-round pick back in 2012.
And similar to his nickname, Russell Wilson has a dangerous mix of skills, the ability to throw from the pocket and extend plays and throw on the run. Not to mention an absolute winner. Usually has his...
And that's caught inside the 35. Play of the game.
First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Check 41.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Here's Wilson. That's complete to DK Metcalf. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard. Again, Wilson. And he's gonna go down. They sack him back right around the 30. Whitney Mercilus barreling in for the sack.
What's up about team for competitively match, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between let them score a touchdown.
And it's a fake. He's going to throw it. Now a throw caught by one of their linemen. And they're able to pick up the first and keep possession. A big play there on the fake field goal. A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. Dumps this one off to Chris Carson. Nice gain of 8 that time, and it's second and goal.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the back.
Touchdown! Will Dislin, a 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Seahawks take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drives 7 plays in length, and it all culminates with a Seattle score. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. Out comes Deshaun Watson, ready to captain the ship here for this Houston offense.
And he's exactly the man you want in control of your offense. Excellent arm, good zip on the ball, not afraid to use his legs when he needs to. And what he's excelled at doing is making plays when the first read isn't available or when the pressure's about to get to him.
Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. He's trying to get that to Brevin Jordan. Back to the air, Watson on second down. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Here's Watson. Working the middle, and he's got it complete to Akins, the tight end. It's a gain of 6, but not enough, as he'll be forced to punt on their first drive of the game. Now on fourth down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. Here comes Reed. Sacked
so dangerous with a football in his hands. Call that a return of 38. And it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. He hits his target, Lockett. Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown.
It's not much as perfect in football, but that's about as close to it as you're going to get. Score, force a punt, score again.
And both drives were impressive. The opening drive was, that last one was. Now on the other side, though, what's your psyche? You're really behind the eight ball.
You got to make sure you just hold in there. Survive the early storm, relax a little bit, and try and get back to your game plan. It's way too early for panic.
Here's Myers now to kick it away. Roberts electing not to try it, and this will come out to the 25. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And they'll start the drive on the ground with Johnson. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Now it's Watson. That's complete to the tight end, Akins. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. To throw is Watson. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. After the interception, here's Wilson. Space to run past the 20. And he's going to get it all the way down to the 10-yard line. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to play, first half, it's 14 to nothing. They go back to Carson here on second. And he is unable to get in. They stop him at the line of scrimmage. On third down, it's Carson. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. And they'll turn to a power game to try to get in. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Nick Ballore, fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that makes the score 21-0. For the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And Roberts choosing not to bring this one out. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they're in an early hole. First drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown. So decent size deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan? Or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Now Watson. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Here's Cameron Johnston now as he'll punt it away for the second time. Oh, the return is Reed. A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead, should they so choose. And he'll get this up to about the 40. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Here's Carson. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. So we are at halftime here in downtown. Due to time constraints, we move you forward in today's broadcast to the beginning of the 3rd quarter. The Texans down on the scoreboard, but they do get the first crack here as we are back underway in the 2nd half. Here's the all-pro returner from 2018, Andre Roberts, and able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them. And the result here, the same as the last play. Another tackle behind the line of scrimmage by the Seahawk defense. And they'll try and run the option to pick it up. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4.
I see a shake of the head as he gets up, and you've got to imagine he's thinking, guys, you got to help me out. He's hoping his team can read his thoughts because he definitely needs some assistance.
He'll return it from the 6. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They'll start out on the ground with Carson, and he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up. They go back to Carson here on 2nd. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. On 3rd down, Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. Finding some room at midfield. And finally brought down at the 43.
A whole lot of open space out in front of him, wasn't it? I'm telling you, Brandon, when things are going right, they are going right.
And everything has been going their way for the most part. I saw that lane start in a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Justin Reed. And the Texans are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. Watson will bring up the Texans here 1st and 10 at their own 18. Starts with a completion, left side. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. 4 yards on the pickup. 2nd and 6 at the 22-yard line. Watson. It's hauled in by Brandon Cooks. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
A gain of 18 on the play. And the
and that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Now a 1st down throw, Watson. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Under 4 to go now as they come up on 2nd down. Watson now to throw. Couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. The Texans on 3rd down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. A shotgun snap for Watson. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them to the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well-prepared.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it is 28-0. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Roberts electing not to try it, and this will come out to the 25. The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And you can sort of sense their dejection. That last pick six put the icing on the cake, so to speak, in what has been a rough go for them. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Out of the gun, Watson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right, with this deficit. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Pass complete from Watson to Akins. That catch good for 5. It's third down. From the gun, here's Watson. He finds Randall Cobb on the completion. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 24-yard line. This is caught. It's Cooks. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. And that is caught. Well, they're going to see this one to the end. They get a score, but pretty much an exercise in futility right now. Still down big. Kaimi Fairbairn on for the extra point. He's got it to bring it back to 28-7 now. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it results in the Texans finding the end zone. So after the touchdown, here's Fairbairn now to kick it away. This is DJ Reed returning. Oh, a good looking return set up here. And they're going to have good starting field position. He's out of bounds, but not before he's across the 35. The Seattle offense now set to come back out on the field. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all 3 timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. He was brought down by Kabu Grugier-Hill. They go back to Carson here on second. And able to get this one all the way up to about the 46-yard line. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. On third down, it's Carson. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And one of the whistles for a timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. On first down, Carson. Solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. And they just took a timeout with 2 seconds to go. This one obviously decided. Not sure they needed to take it, but we'll take it with them. Oh, Wilson gonna throw. Flushed out right. And he'll go down at the 28. So the victory here for Seattle, and it was their defense that really paved the way to this victory as they allowed the one touchdown, and that was all she wrote.
Almost want to do the defense chant right now, right? Defense with a couple of claps in there, but no one wants to hear that from me. Let's just talk about how they got it done, though. When you take care of every aspect of the game, shut down the run, control the airways, right? Make sure the quarterback is harassed. This type of performance you get. They can't fashion together any offense, no consistency, and they just took control.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. It's a win for the Seahawks here as we say so long from Seattle. City. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Detroit Lions. Still going. And he will score. Touchdown, Seahawks. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him. Kick it to him. The way he runs as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that makes the score 7-0. So now the other return teams out there as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. On first down, it's gone. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw, Goff. And his throw here is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Second and 10, Goff again. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
I didn't like the look of that play right from the beginning. I thought he should have seen the coverage that was there, tried to force it in. That one, he's fortunate, just fell incomplete.
Throwing on third, Goff. Open man, he's got him, the tight end, Hockenson. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. A gain of four, not enough, and it looks like punt time on their opening drive as it's fourth down. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Now this is fielded in the end zone. And he'll be tackled inside his own 15. The decision to bring it out cost him some yardage. A good return there, 17 yards. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. On first down, Wilson. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. Well, this is taken in. It's complete.
Is that it?
And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf. Excellent work there to get in on the touchdown run. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. And there, Charles, he lined up out left, ran the post, caught it over the middle, and the rest, as they say, is history.
And you have to love the scheme that they just showed there, because if you're going to run a deep post, you ordinarily have to get a safety out of the middle of the field. And you do it one of two ways, either by running routes at him that carries him away from it, or you either freeze him in the middle with routes that run underneath so that he doesn't get depth. Then you throw it over the top, and boy, what a successful play that was.
No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. One of the best of the last decade or so, Bobby Wagner in to bring him down. Now on second and 13, Goff. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. Here's Jack Fox now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is fielded at the 27. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. This is the Oklahoma State alum, Chris Carson. Room here to run. Ooh, the juke. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. 45 yards for Chris Carson. And the Seahawks are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Boy, these guys are off to the races, Charles. 20-0 already, extra point pending.
Yeah, you always hear that term, they just boat race someone. Heck, it's car race, motorcycle race, plane race, whatever you want. Right now, they are sprinting past them.
Myers connects on the PAT, and it's now 21-0. So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. Khalif Raymond now. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he stopped immediately there. Calling no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Now gone. Got a man. It's Breshon Perriman. And it's out. He put it on the carpet, and the Seahawks have picked it up. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case wide receiver, you got to be careful.
You certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake in the ball and knock it free.
So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10.
To throw is Wilson. Flush to his right. He'll get 10 there all on his own, but it'll be second down. Seahawk football here to start quarter number two. 21-0, our score after one. And he is going to lose yardage here. They call it a loss of a yard there. And that is going to set up a third and one. Now Wilson. Touchdown, Seahawks. Chris Carson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Seahawks continue to pull away here in this first half. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you're doing. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Taken at the goal line. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
You're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Goff on first down. It's caught on the right side, Williams. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A good pickup there, 8 yards in the first down completion. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as a tackle is going to be made at the Seahawks 36. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Gone. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. The hit comes late. We saw it. There's your flag.
And we know that there's a guideline, right? Ball's gone. You get one step. If you're within one step of the quarterback, you can hit him as long as it's still done legally. But anything outside of that, looks like an extra step was involved.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. On first and 10, it's Wilson. And a dangerous throw there, incomplete. He threw that into coverage. It was nearly intercepted. To throw again on second down. Wilson, he'll rifle this one deep right side. He's got a man, complete. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Russell Wilson with 2 first-half touchdown passes. And the Seahawks open the lead up to 34-0. The extra point now coming from Myers. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. The long touchdown pass gets him 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Here's Khalif Raymond to return. Raymond.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Throwing again on second down, Goff. And the Seahawk defense gets to him and they bring him down. L.J. Collier able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. Not wanting to risk another sack, they'll play it safe with a run. And this will go as a short gain on what will be the final act of this first half. And just like that, on we head to half number two. It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. Raymond now on the return. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go? Down the numbers. There he goes. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A big play that time through the air. 31 yards.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far. And never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Here's Goff. Middle of the field to Allison. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Oh, he's hitting off the football, put it on the carpet, and the Seahawks have picked it up. This one back. It's a fumble recovery and a Seattle touchdown. Oh, backbreaker. That'll drive the coach. The offensive coordinator just crazy. You get it all the way down there in the red zone. Can't capitalize. Instead, they go the other way on the fumble return for a touchdown.
How about the aggressiveness of the defense, though? They're not about to just fall on a fumble, are they? Scoop and score is their motto, and they just did it.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And they weren't on the sidelines for long, but I'll tell you what, I'm glad you and I weren't down there. We could hear them, the coaches from all the way up here. They were adamant, you've got to hold on to the football or else we have no hope.
Yeah, it's easy for me to laugh sitting up here, but you're exactly right. We were down there, that message would have been received a whole different way. Because turnovers, they've been a big problem for them. Got to take care of the football. Got to hold on to it.
On second down, Swift. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. To throw is gone. And that will be incomplete.
We went with the dive look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs. Blanketed everyone. Took away all the passing angles. Thus, the incompletion.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. This is taken at the 15. So a 56-yard punt, they'll net 31 after the 15. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have the...
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jamie Collins able to get in there and drop him behind the line. So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. Wilson.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And got his man complete. And all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Seahawks are able to extend their lead in the final seconds of this third quarter. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that will extend this big lead. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays. The long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those and now another turnover as this one's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And the return will stop right around the 25. So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. Three quarters have come and gone. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second down now, it's Carson. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 54 yards rushing for him now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much for the first three quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
Yeah, not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well for them now. As you noted, they want to ride him down the stretch. He should have fresh legs.
Second down, ball on the 3. First down marker at the 1 yard line. Draw play, this is Carson. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all three phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film you just flush and never go back and review. And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
To throw again on second down, Goff. He's got his tight end over the middle, T.J. Hockenson. And now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. And the Seahawks have picked it up. Turn comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Okay, this isn't one where you want to take the game tape and hold it up as an example, do you? I mean, you talk about frustrating all the way through. And that last error, I think that crystallizes it, doesn't it?
Absolutely. That's been representative of their entire game still being shut out. 2 yards the gain on the keeper, and it's second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. Escaping the pressure right. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
He's starting to fall into the category of not fair. Because when he's on target throwing the ball, he's dangerous. But when you add in his ability to make plays with his feet, almost impossible.
Yeah, exactly. They've had trouble stopping him in the secondary. This time they've got the great coverage. Oh, he can run too. And the Seahawks are looking at first and goal as he's tackled all the way down at the 2 yard line. Wilson wants to throw it. pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10. It'll go as a loss of 8 and a tough result there on first and goal. On second and goal, Wilson eluding the pressure right. They give him 10 that time as he was able to get away from the pressure and get a nice game. About a half yard from the end zone, third and goal. Now it's Wilson. And he's going to go down. This will count as a sack, a very short sack, taken down at the 2. And the defense rises to the challenge. They get him down for a loss of 2, and it brings up fourth and goal. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. He had 3 touchdowns already, but won't get a 4th here. And the Lion defense able to come up there with a goal line stand. From the end zone, gone. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. And with inside of 10 seconds, 8 to be precise, we get whistles and a timeout on the field. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Goff, now a desperation throw deep downfield. And he drops it incomplete. And their struggles continue here. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. One last throw here for Goff. He's got his man, T.J. Hockenson. And he is going to have a Lions first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. So the victory here for Seattle. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory. Partner Charles Davis and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Ford Field.